Appeals. The board is here tonight to work together with all of you, the property owners, the neighbors, the architects, to continue the tradition that allows community members to work together to preserve the qualities and unique character that make Lake Forest a special community. We recognize the personal importance of each petitioner's request, and our goal is to respect the requests of the owner while balancing the interests of the community as a whole. For those of you who are not familiar with the Zoning Board of Appeals, the board hears all requests for variations in zoning and special use permits. And the City of Lake Forest is committed to conducting open meetings. To achieve that goal, the board has adopted meeting procedures that ensure that all parties have an opportunity to speak. Procedures are detailed on the agendas available at the back of the room, and this meeting is also broadcast on cable television, where we enjoy a very broad audience. Speaking on behalf of the entire board and city staff, our goal is to move each petition through the review process as quickly as possible, while at the same time balancing the interests of the petitioners, neighboring property owners, and the larger community. I now ask the board members to introduce themselves.
Stuart Dixon, Ward 2.
Angela Deedall, Ward 4.
Sam Ciccarelli, Ward 3.
And I'm Dan Jessica in the 4th Ward. And staff, who we have with us tonight?
Megan O'Neill.
Kathy Cerniak.
We have two petitions. If anyone is thinking that they may be offering testimony today, what I'd like to do is go ahead and swear everyone in right now, if that's okay. So if you anticipate giving testimony today, if you could stand up, raise your right hand, and do you solemnly declare and affirm that the testimony you're about to give is true and correct to the best of your knowledge?
I do.
Thank you. First item on our agenda are the minutes from the January 24th meeting. Does anyone have any comments or suggested changes?
I have none.
Motion to accept the minutes as proposed for the January 24th meeting.
Second.
Second by Angela. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Minutes of January 24 are approved. Next item up on our agenda is a new petition. It's a request for an approval of a variance from a side yard setback requirement to allow construction of an addition at 319 Woodland Road. Preliminarily, are there any conflicts of interest or ex parte communications by any of the board members?
None
by me either. So with that, I would ask for the presentation of the petitioner's petition.
Good evening, Chairman Jessica, Commissioners. My name is John Krasnodebski. I'm the architect for this project. And we're here tonight to request a variance to the side yard setback to 319 East Woodland. And it's owned by Chris and Mary Bowder, joined here tonight by Mary Bowder. And we've done a lot of work on this home in the past, and what we're asking for tonight is a relatively small mudroom addition on the side of the home. The size of the addition is 4 feet by 9 feet wide. And I'll start out with showing you some photographs of the home and the neighborhood. And as you can see, this is the front elevation, and it's a relatively modest-sized home for the lot. It conforms in all respects only for this side yard and the garage projection that exists right now. There's an existing nonconformity with the garage, and I'll show you that in another photograph. This is a picture of the back of the home. This is a view of the yard in the back, looking to the west. This is a view looking to the east. So there's a lot of mature landscaping and a nice stockade fence around the home. Moving on, here's a nice view of the front of the house. And so this is the existing garage that about 5 feet of the western end is non-conforming to the side yard setback. There is a 12-foot requirement for the setback, and that's the variance we requested. Here is a view of the home looking at it from the street, and you can see there's a lot of mature landscape. There's a large, tall stockade fence, and so it's very difficult to see where this addition is going to be, actually. So we benefit greatly from the extensive screening and the distance from the street. So the impact is very low of this addition. So here is, I don't think you'll even maybe you'll see a bit of the shingle, the roof. It's a one-story addition. It's matching the eave line that exists. It's just going to be very low. This is a view across the street to the north, and this is a streetscape looking to the east. So here we have a detail of where this addition is going to occur. So right now, there is a recessed entry. This is a side entry. And so part of the new work is going to encapsulate this area and then project out, I think it's 4 feet, I'll look at the plan, 4 feet from this wall. And so the eave lines are going to match. All the materials will match. It'll blend in very well. It'll have the appearance of always being there once it's completed. So, and this is a view of the neighbor to the west. And so you can see there's a nice screen there. There is a tree here that we intend to keep, even though it is a Siberian elm, which is an invasive species, so it's not your typical elm tree. It was planted in the 60s. It's a fast-growing tree, but we do intend on keeping it, so we'll do the root pruning and all the measures that we can make to try to preserve that tree. So this shows a nice diagram of where the addition is occurring. This is the site. This is the 12-foot side yard setback line. So you can see the non-conforming existing garage space. So we did further mitigate the impact of the addition by stepping the western wall back from the existing non-conforming garage in an effort to alleviate the impact. It's a very small mudroom, 7 feet by 9 feet. And so you can kind of see the shaded area. So that portion right there is what we're asking your approval for. And this is a rendering of the west elevation. You can see how the shed roof is continuous, and then the same materials that's on the existing home will be utilized for this addition. And then here's a view of what that projection, this pochéd shingle area, is the addition from the south. We were here last night to seek approval for Historic Preservation Commission for this addition and this. There's no non-conforming zoning elements on this, so I won't dwell on that portion of it. But it was approved by the HPC last night. So we're here tonight for this portion. And here's a plan view of the mudroom. You can see it's very modest. We did explore other locations for this, but this is the existing side entry. There's the existing staircase, existing kitchen, and the garage doors right here. So it all makes perfect sense to have it in this location, and it just didn't work from a plan standpoint in other locations. So we felt this was the best location. And, you know, with the distance from the street and mature landscaping, we felt that this was the best option and a fairly successful design element. So, you know, we do believe it meets all the criteria for a zoning variance, so we hope that you'll be able to approve that. And if you have any questions, I'd be happy to answer them. Thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Krasnodebski. Staff, identification of issues.
Thank you, Acting Chairman Jessica. this item is before the board as a request for a side yard setback addition on the... What direction is that?
West.
West side, thanks. To allow the mudroom addition. It is part of a larger project that was touched on by the petitioner. The project as a whole was reviewed by the Historic Preservation Commission last night, and a certificate of appropriateness was granted at that time. During this process of looking at the design, the petitioner did look at alternatives and explore ways to reduce the encroachment into the side yard setback, minimize the impact of the additions. And the current proposal that's before you tonight for approval steps the addition back from the furthest point of encroachment, of existing encroachment at the garage. And really looking at the interior space, the location made sense from a functionality. And this type of project is one that we often see with older homes. This, as was mentioned, it's in the historic district, and the modest additions are an attempt to keep the home viable for the future. The property is in the R2 district. There was a city-initiated and approved zone change since this house was built, creating a hardship for complying with the zoning requirements that are in place today. As part of the historic preservation's approval, a landscape plan will be looked at should that Siberian elm be impacted during construction. If you have any questions, I'd be happy to answer it. There are findings of fact to support the variance in your staff report. With that, I'll turn it over to the board.
Thank you. Does the board have any questions for either staff or the petitioner?
No questions.
No questions.
I have one question for the petitioner. There's the fence that's right next to it. How tall did you say that was?
I believe it's a 6-foot tall stockade fence.
And is that going to be impacted by the construction activities, or will that be able to remain standing during construction?
It's going to remain in place.
Okay, it's a
right.
small enough.
We can do the excavation by hand, so it's small enough that we can accommodate construction without moving the fence.
Okay, great. Thank you.
The only question I have is I assume since the time of the staff report, there's been no further contact by any of the neighbors who might have received notice.
That's correct.
Are there any members of the public who are here who would wish to address this agenda item? Seeing none, an opportunity for any final questions by staff or questions of staff or the petitioner. And finally, does the petitioner have any closing statements he wishes or they wish to make?
Nice.
Board discussion.
I have no issues.
I have no issues.
I mean, it seems to me a very reasonable request, and I would support it.
I agree.
Thank you.
Anyone want to make a motion?
Sure. I move to recommend approval of variance as submitted in the staff based on findings in the staff report. The complete staff report, the materials included in the pack, and the public testimony are incorporated as part of its findings.
Is there a second?
Second.
Any further discussion?
No.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? 4-0, the recommendation of the Zoning Board of Appeals would be to approve the variation. Thank you for your time this evening. The next agenda item is a request for a approval of a variance from a rear yard setback requirement to allow the reconstruction of the garage at 48 Woodland Road. And first I would ask the board members if there are any conflicts of interest or ex parte communications.
None.
None.
I don't have any either. Petitioner's previously been sworn in, so I would turn it over to the petitioner to make their presentation.
You're hired.
George Svoboda, the architect for the project.
George.
Mr. Svoboda, could you pick up the microphone, perhaps?
George Svoboda, the architect for the project. And, site plan here. Of course, originally, evidently, the house was oriented to be along Woodland Road, and the side yard would have been 12 feet, which we have 20 feet to the front edge there. I don't know if we can incorporated in this part here. Now, where, you can see this is a single-family ranch-type house, and we intend to put a second floor on here, which let me get back to that other one. Adding a second floor here, and we're not really touching this except to replace the brick, replace the windows in the back end. And as you can see, this line represents the 35-foot setback as being a rear yard. And in the Mr. O'Neill said, let's come back here in case, in reconstructing the brick and all this, that something happens, that the thing falls down or something, that we have your approval to reconstruct as is, with the exception of no brick and no windows in the rear. The rear, I can show, we're back again. See on the left side over here, we got new windows going in there, and that would be about the extent of the project, except in a brick. And now let's get the picture. This is the existing front of the house, and this is the back end of the garage area. You can see some windows over on the side there. This is a streetscape with the edge of the house, the edge of the garage there, and the next door neighbors. This is a house to the north on Green Bay Road. And that's the house across the street from on Green Bay Road. This is the north west elevation, which would be the front yard. And you can see the trees and all that kind of stuff that we want to maintain. And this is a Google map view where all that's. Basically,
okay. Thank you. Staff, identification of issues.
Thank you, Acting Chairman Jessica. This is one where staff really struggled as to whether or not it was necessary to bring this petition before the Zoning Board of Appeals. I think in an effort to be transparent, and because the existing garage is within the setback area, it is appropriate for the Zoning Board to take action on this item. The request before you is really part of a larger reconstruction or construction project to allow a second floor addition that involves reconstruction of some walls, the retention of the foundation, and some new massing over the main part of the house, But the idea is to rebuild the garage in the same footprint, no change in height. And for that reason, we're asking the zoning board to review this and to provide input and take action if you find it appropriate. The property is in the R2 district. The home is oriented to face Woodland Road. However, the rear yard is actually measured from the east property line, which, as you're looking at the house, could be perceived as a side yard.
Bless you.
Bless you. So the setback to the, from the east is a 35-foot setback. Currently, the garage is sited at its closest point at 20 feet. The new construction that raises the wall height is all in compliance with the current zoning that's on the property today. I think there's a couple things for this that are important to note for this petition. The petition is scheduled for review by the Building Review Board to look at the architectural elements. The change to the garage will be primarily cosmetic. The zoning variance will allow, you know, the new brick, new windows, possibly some detailing around the eve lines to occur within the setback area. Also, just looking at the site, we have had some neighbors call and questioning the location of the garage and expressing some support for maintaining the garage in the location that it is today, primarily because if a detached garage were constructed, it could be closer to the property line, given current zoning requirements, and also much taller than what's there today. So I think this zoning variance allows it to stay setback the 20 feet from the property line, as well as maintain a more modest profile in terms of the height. Also important is the significant amount of trees and vegetation between the structure and Green Bay Road. I think for any request or any construction project, it's really important to maintain that buffer, and moving the home further west could potentially impact that buffer. The Building Review Board will be looking more at the design of the home. The issue before the zoning board tonight is really the reconstruction of the garage. There are positive findings in the staff report. I'm happy to answer any questions that you may have, but staff is supportive of this request tonight.
Thank you. Does the board have any questions for the petitioner or for the city staff?
I have none.
I have one quick question. Could you clarify a little bit, when you say reconstructing the garage, that just includes, it's not taking the garage down and rebuilding it from the ground up, it's just replacing the facade, basically?
The intent is to maintain as much of the structure as they can, with the exception of some new windows, a new garage door, new facade material. I think given the larger construction project that is happening over the main part of the house, there is some potential for some of the structural members to be removed in order to provide cohesive construction and really connect the existing roof form to the proposed structure. So this variance would allow the reconstruction of the garage with no change to the footprint.
Okay, so if say, you know, some of the other structural members were, you know, inadvertently damaged or something during the rest of the demolition or something, other construction, that would all be covered by this, so it wouldn't have to come back or anything.
Correct.
Okay. All right, thank you.
Any other questions? Hearing none, are there any members of the public who wish to testify before the board today?
Yes. I'm John Krasnodebski. I live in the neighborhood. I live across the street from the Somat 910 Green Bay Road, and that was actually showed in the presentation tonight, the red brick across the street. So I spent some time today looking at the project, and I could see it from every window of my house and from the front yard. So I'm very interested to see what's going on with this project. And my first reaction to it is that I really can't support it from a design standpoint. I think it has a long way to go architecturally. I do understand the need to replace the garage in its current location. I think that's a good thing, replacing its current location. But the project in its entirety is a little bit disconcerting. You know, I think this is basically a full demolition, from what I can tell. the walls are, they're going to try to keep the walls, but, you know, with the windows changing so dramatically, once it's all taken down, it'll be kind of surprising. I've done this, so I know. So I appreciate the effort in saving the footprint and the concrete. That's great, because I think the location of the home is good. You know, I like the footprint. But I think what the board needs to consider is that this is going to be pretty much demolition. And from my experience, demolitions must conform to setbacks. So I think there should be some options shown that show a conforming project, since there's so much being removed. I think it can be done. I've done it. So that's one of my concerns. I think the bigger picture, I think the BRB has a lot to review here. And so I'm not so concerned about the garage. I like its location, like the lowness of it. But the adjacent structure seems to be out of place for the neighborhood. So I'll be at the BRB meeting to discuss that. But I'm just a little concerned that maybe the BRB should first look at it, and then the zoning board weighs in on their reaction. I just think it needs more detail. I think some more schemes that maybe show how a garage could work in a conforming nature might be a good thing to see. It is a gateway. I know, you know, there's a lot of traffic that goes through there. I notice that on a daily basis. I'm in it. A lot of people go to the high school along Woodland. And so it gets a lot of visibility. And so I think this is a great opportunity to really create something that contributes to the neighborhood. Right now, I don't think it's there. I think it's, with a little more effort, it can get there. I support improving this property because it's been in disrepair for quite some years. So I think it's great to improve it. And it's about time it gets improved, but very long way to go. So I hope that you take another look at it. And I think something can be done that's much better for the neighborhood. So thanks for listening.
Thank you, Mr. Krasnodebski. Final opportunity for the board to ask questions of petitioner or, I'm sorry.
My name is Roger Lee. I'm actually petitioner's son. I am stepping up. I only was asked to come here and support in terms of seeing what was going on in this process. As we were a little confused at first as why we were in front of the board, as Ms. O'Neill had stated before, but evidently that's because of a variance issue that possibly has arisen, because if something happens, then it might possibly need to be rebuilt. But from what I heard tonight, I have to disagree respectfully. I know that we have been building and doing construction for over 35, 40 years now. And we do not intend to do any kind of work in terms of a total deconstruction or demolition. We intend to fully use the full footprint and the original structure in terms of the, you know, location. And if you take a look at the pictures, seeing around the neighborhood has changed a lot. We are stuck in a ranch, trying to improve it to now a Georgian two-story. And as it is, like I said, I've heard other comments here tonight, and I just wanted to tell the board that we do not plan to do anything that would be outside of what we've submitted, and let it fall where it be, and let you make your decision. Okay. Thank you very much.
And we sort of jumped ahead to rebuttal, but before we get to the final petitioner's rebuttal, questions of the board to either staff or to the petitioner or their representatives. I guess my question would be, what is staff's sort of response or position with respect to looking at alternatives that would not have required a variation for the reconstruction of this building? And is that something that you think is warranted under these circumstances?
The board certainly could request that in this case. The intent of this project is to retain the foundation, and since the foundation is within the setback area, that intent would have to shift in order to look at alternative plans. But it would not be inappropriate to ask for that exploration in order to justify and support this request. That being said, I do agree with the public comment that there is some design work that still needs to occur. This is a very prominent corner. The Building Review Board is, they're charged with looking at the design and making sure that those details are executed appropriately, and this item is scheduled for consideration by the Building Review Board. We try not to bounce petitioners back and forth between boards as much as possible. I think if you do need to see this again, that's fine, but I think we should get some direction from the board if the design were to be improved, if this type of request could be supported.
Any other questions from any of the board members?
You mentioned that there was some neighbor feedback. Could you perhaps discuss that in a little more detail?
Sure. Staff received a phone call from the neighbor directly east of this petition, mainly inquiring as to what the project entailed. And we answered their questions that the garage is not getting closer to their property or taller in any way, and that seemed to satisfy their questions.
Great.
We did also receive a phone call from the property owner across the street, expressing similar concerns as was expressed by Mr. Krasnodebski tonight, that the design really needs some work, and that alternatives could be reviewed that didn't require a zoning variance.
We could approve the variance for the, actually what's before us now is just to approve the variance for the garage, and we could do that, and then it still has to go to Building Review Board to approve the design.
That's correct. And the cosmetics of the garage may change, but the massing and the footprint would be consistent with a variance if one was approved tonight.
Any other questions? I guess my question is, with respect to the BRB, would they look at things like the aesthetic of having the garage in that location is inappropriate, and therefore we would like you to go back and look at rebalancing the house or reconfiguring the house structure? Or is that not something they would take into consideration?
The Building Review Board is looking at the project as a whole. They're looking at the way the masses relate to each other, the way the mass relates to neighboring properties, the architectural detailing, the compatibility with an architectural style, which speaks to some of those connection points between subordinate masses and larger masses. So yes, they do take the whole picture into account.
And I would just add that your approval tonight, you know, we're always trying to balance which board comes first, and your approval tonight would not take precedence or would not direct that the Building Review Board act in any certain way. The Building Review Board still on its own really has to be convinced that the demolition is justified, that the replacement structure is appropriate for that site and for the overall neighborhood. So certainly we could bring this back to you if after the Building Review Board's action, but I also think there wouldn't be any harm. We wouldn't take it forward to the City Council for final approval until the Building Review Board had signed off. So it's either way, I think it's appropriate. It's just, we're just trying to, this was a tough one to figure out which should come first.
Provide convenience for the petitioner.
Right.
And the zoning board just happened to fall.
Yeah, no, it makes sense. Yeah.
Any other questions?
No.
Petitioner opportunity for any rebuttal.
I think we're all good.
Okay. Then I think it's up to board discussion, deliberation. Stuart?
I think it's been pretty well articulated. If the concern in the discussion is about the design, that's out of our wheelhouse. It's our lens is the variance for the garage, and I think that's where it falls, and that's where the discussion should focus, not about the design, not about the aesthetic. So that's something that we need to weigh as part of the decision-making process.
Angela?
I agree. I feel the main concerns appear to be centering around the design itself. And as I look at, if I look solely at the zoning considerations and the request for the variance, I don't see any issue with this variance with respect to zoning. I think it's very similar to other things that we have approved and we've found appropriate in the past. So I would have no problem supporting a variance for the garage tonight. I don't see a need to delay this petition.
I would agree.
Any other thoughts? Yeah, I do too. I think, you know, I've been aware of this house for a period of time and it's been in sort of need of some attention. You know, BRB, I think that's their domain to look at that. I haven't heard anyone, staff, public testimony suggesting that the variance is the problem. The problem resides in things other than what we are charged to look at. So I would agree that we could recommend approval of the variance and let the BRB do their review. Any other discussion or thought? Any motions anyone wants to make?
Sam, you want to hoist one up?
Sure. I move to recommend the approval of the variance as submitted based on the findings stated in the staff report dated March 24th, 2011. The complete staff report, the materials included in the packet, and the public testimony are incorporated as part of the findings.
Second.
Any further discussion? All in favor of the motion as stated, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Hearing no opposition, by a 4-0 vote, the recommendation of the Zoning Board of Appeals is to recommend approval of the variance as proposed. And the next agenda item is an opportunity of the public to address the Zoning Board of Appeals on any matter not on the agenda.
Anyone? Anyone?
Bueller? Hearing nothing. Next is the opportunity for staff to provide the board with any additional information.
On your way out the door, we're going to provide you with some reading material. It is a memo recently prepared by the city attorney for the city council, just as an update, a refresher, a reminder on the State Open Meetings Act. So read at your leisure. If you have questions, don't hesitate to let me know.
And an April meeting is unlikely at this point?
Correct.
Okay.
Great, thank you.
Well, with that, I would say, since we may not meet again, I just really want to say thank you to staff and to everybody who's been on the board over the last 5 years with me. It's been a great, great experience. I think the people of the city are very fortunate to have the staff that we have across the board in the city, and it's been a real pleasure and honor to work with both of you and as well as some of your colleagues. So. Thank you very much.
And we're going to miss Dan and Mike and Angela as you move on off the board. Your service has been terrific, and thank you so much for your commitment to the city of Lake Forest.
It's been a blast.
And, so. And we will invite you back to formally recognize you at one of the next meetings.
Oh, true.
Oh, okay. Perfect. All right.
But thank you for your kind comments.
Great.
You're very welcome. Nothing else, so I would accept a motion to adjourn.
Move to adjourn.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carries. We are adjourned.
So long, everybody.
I got a gal who's always late. Anytime we have a date, but I love her. Yes, I love her. I'm gonna walk right up to her gate and see if I can get it straight, 'cause I want her. I'm gonna ask her, is you is or is you ain't my baby? Way you acting lately makes me doubt. Yous is still my baby, baby. Seems my flame in your heart's done gone out. A woman is a creature that has always been strange. just when you're sure of one, you'll find she's gone and made a change. Is you is or is you ain't, my baby.